Chris, if you're ready, I'm ready. Let's do this shit. Let's talk some motherfucking movies.
It's a show by Chris and Neil with all great movies. They are the real deal. We watch them all, so you don't have to. It's movies that don't suck and some that do.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and children of all ages.
Welcome to a new episode. I really hope children of all ages aren't listening to this.
I know, right? No. welcome to a new episode of Movies That Don't Suck, Some Do. My name is Neil.
I'm Chris.
And we are the two head honchos of the movie reviewing. We are the Robert and S. Ebert? Was it Ebert?
Roger Ebert and the Gene Siskel.
It's the Siskel and Ebert of 2021. Soon to be 2022. Yeah. We are the greatest, the best. We like getting drunk and reviewing movies. First today, up on the board is, which is funny because the movie is Don't Look Up, featuring every damn person you like in movies. Leonardo DiCaprio.
I'm having panic attacks, all right? The other night I thought I was having a fucking heart attack. I puked in a trash barrel on the way over here. I haven't slept for fucking weeks.
Is that true?
Yeah, that's true, all right? I said something fucking true. I want some fucking pills, and you're gonna what? You're gonna close my file?
Is that what you're gonna do? I know.
I thought I was supposed to tell the truth here,
Christ,
when a guy comes in here against every instinct of privacy, of self-reliance that he has, and what do? What do you do, huh? You send him off on the street to score smack? Is that what you do?
That's from The Departed.
The Departed.
Yeah,
The Departed. There's nothing wrong with The Departed. I love The Departed. The Departed is one of my favorite movies of all time. Literally, if I'm like a vegetable and brain dead, just replay like The Departed, Boondock Saints, and all of Batman the Animated Series. Okay. That's literally it, and I'll be fine. I'll be happy in my world. Also co-starring in this movie, the wonderful J-Law herself, Jennifer Lawrence.
Oh, Carmine, with the one that Carmine gave me. Carmine.
Why don't you just marry Carmine? Get a little gold microwave and put it on a chain around your neck. You want to be more like Carmine? Why don't you build something like he does? Instead of all your empty deals, it's just like your fucking science oven. You know, I read that it takes all of the nutrition out of our food. It's empty, just like your deals. Empty.
So, ever since I've seen American Hustle, I don't call it microwave anymore. I call it science oven.
It's a science machine. It's a science oven.
Yeah.
I love it. It's like my wife one time messed up and called tongs. She called them salad utensils. And ever since then, I say salad utensils. Mm-hmm. She hates me for it, but I think it's great. I think it's great stuff.
It's very funny.
Yeah. Let's see. Who else is
Meryl Streep's in this? Meryl Streep.
Oh, Meryl Streep!
You make concessions when you're married a long time, but you don't believe you'll make when you're beginning. When you're young, you say, oh, I'll never tolerate this or that or the other thing. But time goes by, darling. And when you've slept together 1,000 nights and you've smelled like spit up from the babies when they're sick and you've seen your body droop and get soft, and some nights you just think, oh God, I'm not going to put up with it another minute. But you wake up in the next morning and the kitchen smells like coffee and the kids have their hair brushed all by themselves, and you look at your husband and no, he's not the person you thought he was, but he's your life.
Yeah.
Well, that is Meryl Streep from her Academy Award winning, what was that? Wasn't it called like 100 Days or something like that? Or
I don't know. I don't fucking know. Are we really going to do this?
Yeah, do what? Kick you in the face?
No, just like figure out what it was, like while we're on air.
I totally forgot. I can't help it. I hate when I do that because I'm the one that picks the one true thing. That's what it was from. Cool.
Also, this has
Kate Blanchett.
Yeah. You didn't give me
Rob Morgan.
Yeah.
Tyler Perry. The great Ron Perlman.
Yeah, Timothy Chalamet is in it. Mark Rylance.
Yeah, but also one of my favorite guys. He's going to be playing Jerry Garcia soon.
I know.
And if you haven't seen him, if you haven't seen him lately, holy fuck, he looks like Jerry Garcia right now. Mr. Jonah Hill.
People are overlooked for a variety of biased reasons and perceived flaws. Age, appearance, personality. Bill James and mathematics cut straight through that. Billy, of the 20,000 notable players for us to consider, I believe that there is a championship team of 25 people that we could afford because everyone else in baseball undervalues them. Like an island of misfit toys.
Yeah, that's from Moneyball. So,
yes, which I've actually watched this week.
Yeah.
Because I haven't watched it in a long time.
It's a good movie.
And it's a great movie. Like, seriously, have you seen Jonah Hill lately?
Yeah, I haven't looked at, I mean, the past couple weeks now. You show me, you gonna send me a video or you didn't show me? Okay, hold on.
Dude, he was like ridiculous. Like, he looks like, I'll show you here in about 2 seconds, but like, literally, he's transformed himself into the person he wants to be. And I'm excited for him for that because I think we'd all should take those journeys in life where you need to figure out who you are, what you are, and things like that. But this is literally what he looks like. I can only go so fast. This computer only goes so fast. Are you
sharing the screen?
Look at him. Yeah, like, dude, I can't wait. I want to see him as Jerry Garcia. Yeah. I'm totally want to see him as Jerry Garcia now.
So that's Don't Look Up. We'll be talking about that first. What's the second movie talking about?
The second movie, you guys all know it. It's the one, the only. The big movie of the week. Everybody was talking about it for all of 2021 until it came out, and that is The Matrix Restructions.
Resurrections.
That's what I said. Restructions.
Resurrections.
Restructions. Resurrections. Featuring one of the greatest men on earth, not just actors, but just one of the greatest human beings, especially when somebody like Stephen Colbert asks you the question, Keanu Reeves, what happens when you die?
When and Helen answers, died, I
lost. He answers,
when Helen died, I lost.
No, 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 that's not. You are jumping the gun on things here. No, Stephen Colbert asks Keanu Reeves, when you die, what happens? And he goes, he just took like a deep thought for a second and goes, I know the ones that love you will miss you. Oh, Keanu Reeves.
When Ellen died, I lost everything. Until that dog arrived on my doorstep. A final gift from my wife. In that moment, I received some semblance of hope. An opportunity to grieve unalone. And your son took that from me. Stole that from me. Killed that from me.
And that's when you don't want to fuck over John. That's when you don't want to, you know, cross John Wick.
John Wick. Also in this movie, the great, the wonderful Carrie Ann Moss.
Try this one. They were exposed to a toxic gas leak. Or there's something in the water or subliminal advertising. I had dozens of justifications. I just didn't want to believe it. Even as more people were hurt or killed.
Are you testifying, Jerry?
No, no need. I will have more than enough testimony to convince a jury that this man forced Jessica to snap his own neck.
Yeah, what's that from again?
That is from Jessica Jones.
Okay, cool.
One of her greatest acting performances. She was in all the episodes, the entire two or three seasons of Jessica Jones. She was also in Daredevil. She was, I think, she No, she didn't pop up in The Punisher, I don't think. But yeah, oh, amazing, amazing actress. And there's plenty of other people in this film, but they didn't have enough clips that I could grab from them. Like, you go ahead and name them off.
So we got Yahya Abdul-Mateen II as Morpheus. Jonathan Groff, you guys know from Hamilton, played Smith. And Jessica Henwick as Bugs.
And I am so happy to see you. I'm not the same person that I used to be, you know? 7 years, it's a long time. I've lost people. My mom, my friends. Last year I lost someone. And he meant a lot to me.
That's from Love and Monsters.
Yes, and then the one person that you have not mentioned.
Yeah, yeah.
Mr. Legendary himself. Neil Patrick Harris.
10 things I would have called my truck if Ted hadn't been a jerk and given it back. The Winnebago, the pickup truck, the Ford Explorer, the U-Scream truck, Feels on Wheels, hello, the 18 Squealer, the Escalade, the Slamboni, the 69 Chevy.
I like the Slamboni part.
I think it's amazing. I think it's awesome.
Also, the stars Jada Pinkett Smith, Priyanka Chopra Jones, Christine Ricci.
Yeah. So many people are in this movie, which is, of course, makes sense because it's The Matrix. I mean, let's say in the 90s, who did not love The Matrix? You know, the original Matrix, yeah. Not the other two, not the sequels, because the sequels, people, oh, it's too sci-fi for, yeah, because the first one wasn't sci-fi at all. You're right. But anyway, let's not have that argument. Chris, tell them where they can find us.
You find us on iMoviesDon'tSuck.net. We're on Facebook, facebook.com/MoviesDon'tSuck Podcast. We're on Twitter, @MTS Podcast. We're on Instagram, @MTS Podcast. We have a Patreon, patreon.com/MoviesDon'tSuck. If you want merch, shirts, go to bonfire.com/MoviesDon'tSuck and something to do. You'll find all kinds of shit on there. We're also on all stream platforms. You're watching on YouTube, go ahead and subscribe. You're watching on Twitch, go ahead and subscribe. Watch on Facebook, go ahead and like that page, subscribe. And we're on all stream platforms. Or, you know, platforms where you download podcasts.
All right, and also for small businesses, everybody around here, we be more than happy to promote. The Rough Stick Cuff is your place for bracelets and any kind of bracelet jewelry that you want. I went there for Christmas to buy my wonderful mother-in-law some wonderful bracelets. Actually, we stumbled upon it. I'm not even gonna lie. We stumbled upon it downtown Tulsa here, and it was amazing. Now, just to tell you a little bit, after falling in love with all things cuff, these people in the late 90s began the search for the perfect one. They loved leather, they loved metal. However, what they came to realize was of joining the two mediums would bring them more satisfaction than either of those alone. Rustic Cuff was created late one night when they grew weary of searching for the perfect cuff and decided to create their own. What started off as a midnight hobby making for friends and family has now turned into a creative outlet and endless ideas and possibilities. You can look them up. They have a wonderful website. Actually, they don't have a website. I'm not finding a website for them. That's weird. Maybe they do. Maybe they don't. I thought, yeah, they do have a website. I don't know why I said none. That's weird. It's at rusticcuff.com, RusticCuff.com. Or you can look them up on Facebook at RusticCuff. Like, literally, some of the coolest things you could find there. They had a bunch of football ones, but they didn't have Notre Dame, which I was really upset about.
Sorry,
I told them.
I know you really wanted.
Yeah. I was like, Notre Dame! And they're like, we don't have the licensing rights to them. And I was like, oh, yeah, because it's Notre Dame! But wonderful people there. They're really nice. We were trying to hide the item we were buying for my mother-in-law, because we're about to meet her up for dinner. Mm-hmm. So they literally held on to ours until the next day. So really nice people. Go ahead. Meet them there. They will love you.
Where can you find them again?
It is at rusticcuff.com.
Okay. So I think that we got all that stuff out of the way. How has your week been?
my week has been amazing.
That's good to hear.
I don't know.
Did you get Christmas?
Huh?
Did you get Christmas?
What did I do on Christmas? I got drunk. No. Man, Christmas Eve, we had a good time.
Yeah.
Got plenty of good gifts. I got my parent, I mean, we both got TVs, it seems, mm-hmm. this year. Because I got a 43-incher in my bar now, because I had that only little 19-incher I had in there. And now I got this 43-incher. We already put it up on the wall. Oh, yeah. We got a new stereo system for our second vehicle. Plenty of cool shirts and T-shirts, like this one right here, my Camp Crystal Lake shirt. I got plenty of Danhausen shirts for my pro wrestling love. I got a humidor and some great cigars.
Nice.
And Chris, you never smoked cigars before.
No, so save one for me when we come down there.
Oh, dude, there's a whole box. If I could go, I'm not a huge cigar smoker, but that's why I wanted a humidor, so I could put them in the humidor and they could keep their cool or keep their freshness. My wife got a bunch of good stuff too. Like, it was a great Christmas. And then Christmas Day, we literally ate prime rib.
Yeah, we got really stoned. Yeah, I had prime rib as well.
And we played a board game of some sort. Oh, it was a board game where you said something. Everybody made up, like, it was kind of like Cards Against Humanity, except for with pen and paper.
Okay.
I guess would be the best way.
It was fun.
Yeah, it was hilarious. It was fun as hell. And then we watched the first movie, Don't Look Up, that we're reviewing today. And, man, I don't know. I had a good time. The rest of the week has just been kind of, like, going so fast.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie. Right now, you can't go to my page, I guess, and look me up, because even right now, I know
I tagged you and myself.
Tagged me, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it still won't. It didn't post it on my page.
Well, I'm sorry, pal.
Yeah, that's all right. But still, because what are we doing tomorrow? Is that we're doing a white trash mystery murder, where you're in a trailer park and you're all people, you know, murdering people. And I said white trash on Facebook, and I didn't know that was hate. I was just saying the name of the game, and I know that's kind of hate speech, I guess.
Yeah,
and
there's my brother used to work for a company that did that moderating stuff for Facebook. They got fired, but not my brother, but the company doesn't do that for anymore. And that was one of the terms that you were not allowed to put on Facebook. So
I did not know that.
Yeah, well, now you
do. People should warn me.
Yeah, now you do. So
I am but one man. I can only do one thing, and that is be weird. Mm-hmm. But So anyway, I'm happy. How did your Christmas turn out?
It was fantastic, dude. We went to Leah's parents' house for Christmas Eve. They do it every year.
Did your brother go with you?
Yeah.
Nice.
I'm not gonna let my brother spend Christmas Eve and Christmas alone. So he came, and we had shrimp. We drank some beers, we played some games, and we were there. And then, we went home after that and came back Christmas morning, and we opened gifts, and we had prime rib. It was a really good time. I had a really good Christmas this year. I got a Fitbit.
Didn't Leah's sister just get engaged too?
Yeah, Leah's sister is now engaged to a friend of the show,
Sarah
McGuire. Yeah, friend of the show.
Yeah, she was one of our first when we did an interview segment once.
She sat in with us. Yeah.
And it was a great time. We are going to be doing some sit-ins here coming up this next year. She was really nice. Both of them are really nice. I met them on several occasions.
Very cool people. I had a great Christmas. I am tomorrow's New Year's Eve. For people who don't know, we're recording this on the day before New Year's, the night before the night. And we are, Neil said he's doing it. He's going to a murder mystery party. I am going just to Cardboard Cafe, play games. But around 3 o'clock tomorrow night, or 3 o'clock Saturday, New Year's Day, we're going to get 5 to 8 inches here in Kansas City of snow. And I have firewood. I have chili fixins. I have curry fixins. I got some wine, and it's going to be cozy and fucking wonderful. I've been waiting to be able to have a cozy weekend in, and this is going to be, I'm super happy about it. So, yeah. When it's finally started here, and I'm honestly pretty happy about it. So,
dude, I'd be great about it. I think it's awesome. I'm just stoked for life. You know what I'm saying? Like, as much as COVID variant's going on, I mean, I've been pricked. I got the vaccine. I'm getting the booster next week. Okay.
I got the booster already. So,
yeah, and it's. I mean, guys, if we just, you know, settle down, take care of it, we can have a good life. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, I'm just excited for 2022 already. I don't know why. I don't know if it has something to do that I'll be in Dallas for a week watching half-naked men beating the hell out of each other. But, you know, when I first moved here, I didn't know exactly how to take the area or whatever. But now that I've met a few people,
It's been like a couple of years now, right?
What, 2 years?
Yeah, 2 years, I think.
2 years, yeah. And I mean, after 40, man, every year is like five whatever. Minutes.
Who gives a fuck?
Yeah. It's 5 minutes, dude. It's no longer like when you're like, you know, 20 and you're like, oh my gosh, it's going to take forever for this. No, now it's just like, oh, so it was 1999. How many weeks ago? That's how it feels, bro. But I'm ready to talk some movies, man. I want to talk some movies. I want to talk some shit. All
right.
I want to talk about the end of the world as we know it. And I feel fine.
So Don't Look Up, directed by Adam McKay. He's done things like Step Brothers, The Other Guys. And then he did The Big Short, which is sort of his sort of kind of drama thing, in Vice. And this is his newest one, Don't Look Up. Who do you think it's written by? Can you guess?
Adam McKay?
Yeah, it is written by Adam McKay as well. And also a story by David Sirota, who he's not really done anything. He wrote this movie. That's all he did.
That's cool.
Yeah. Starring,
it could have been like a, like, do you know about, are you a Highlander fan?
Not really, man. To be honest. But I know they're
like the Highlander?
I know they're going to be the only one.
Yes. So this could have been like Highlander. Like, Highlander was a movie written by college students.
Mm-hmm.
And they gave him like $1,000 or something like that and said, if this makes any money, we'll give you a percentage.
Yeah.
And then the first thing they did was go to Sean Connery because it's a Scotsman. Yeah. And he's like, yeah, I want to do it. And then as soon as Sean Connery did it, like all of a sudden all his money got thrown at them. And the guys made millions of dollars. So hopefully that's how this turns out for these guys.
So this stars Leonardo DiCaprio as Dr. Randall Mindy.
I'm having panic attacks, all right? The other night I thought I was having a fucking heart attack.
And also Jennifer Lawrence as Kate DeBasky.
Carmine gave me. Carmine.
Why don't you just marry Carmine? Get a little gold microwave and put it on a chain around your neck.
Also, Kate Blanchett as Bree Evanti when she was also, she was unrecognizable. Rob Morgan is Dr. Teddy Oglethorpe. Jonah Hill as Jason Orlean.
People are overlooked for a variety of biased reasons and perceived flaws.
Also, the star is Tyler Perry as Jack Bremer. Mike Rylance as Peter Isherwell. Great performance.
Mark Rylance, man. He plays so a geek good. Again. Plays a geek again. How many movies does he play geeks?
I don't know, man. This also stars Meryl Streep as President Orlean.
You make concessions when you're married a long time.
Yeah. And, also, Timothy Chalamet.
Ariana Grande.
Timothy Chalamet is Yule. Ron Perlman is Benedict Drask. Ariana Grande is R.I.B. Kid Cudi is DJ Cello. Melanie Lindsay is June Mindy. Why don't you go ahead and read the storyline? It's a great storyline, too. It's a big one.
Ooh, it's a big one.
Yeah.
All right. Let me. I got to take a sip of my 405 red beer. 405 red beer from Norman, Oklahoma.
It's still the holidays, so holiday cheer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I saw a different Shiner Bock holiday one today.
Mm.
And I was going to buy it.
Let me guess. Is it candied pecans?
No. It was, I saw that one last week, but there's a different one I saw. I was like, Kate, yes.
Kate DeBasky.
Yeah. My throat went out right when I said that. Kate DeBasky, an astronomer grad student, and her professor, Dr. Randall Mindy, make an astounding discovery of a comet orbiting within the solar system. The problem, it's on a direct collision course with Earth. The other problem, no one really seems to care. Turns out warning mankind about a planet killer the size of Mount Everest is an inconvenient fact to navigate. With the help of Dr. Oglethorpe, Kate and Randall embark on a media tour that takes them from office of an indifferent President Orlin and her
sycophantic.
I was belching. I knew the word. I was just trying not to belch in the microphone. And her psychopathic son, chief of the staff, Jason, to the airwaves of the Daily Rip, an upbeat morning show hosted by Bree and Jack. With only 6 months until the comet makes impact, managing the 24-hour news cycle and gaining the attention of social media, obsessed public before it's too late proves shockingly comical. What will it take to get the world to just look up?
So, this is a satire, and it's very thinly held. Think about this.
Fucking great satire! I don't give a shit what anybody has said, because I've seen that there's been negative reviews on this.
Yeah.
And I think the people that are negative reviewing this were all supporters of other presidents that I'm not going to talk about. But because that is what this fucking movie makes fun of. You have a president in office who's got their child next to them as their chief of staff. I don't know who that's making fun of. And then it's also reflecting COVID, to be honest.
Or climate change. Like, climate change is also the same thing. We all know climate change is happening and it was doing anything. So, yeah. It reflects COVID. It talks about, you know, like, people not believing in the fucking science. Like, this is
it's fucking science!
So, like,
it's fucking science, people. There's a thing that I think we all learned about it in like fifth grade. I'm gonna go fifth grade. Yeah, I think you learned about it. The scientific method, creating a hypothesis, going through with it. So you figure out what's fact and what's fiction. It's like fucking created before fucking Einstein, people. Yeah. Like,
and so what this movie is, it also be a horror film. Because it seems like this could be it. This could happen. Because I was watching, I was kind of frightened. But this movie is a hard satire, and it's not subtle in any way. It's one instrument, just fine. In my opinion, it's just a teensy bit too long. You know, you don't think so? That's fine. That's fine.
Okay, I'll agree. A little, maybe not overly long, but let me compare it to the movie I think it is of today.
Okay.
And we'll see what the movie length there was.
Okay.
Okay, yeah, I probably could drop off about 10 minutes.
Yeah.
But, because this is the movie I'm going to compare it to all you movie fans out there. Are you ready for this?
Uh-huh.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
This is Idiocracy. Yeah. 2021.
Yeah, this is bam! It's Idiocracy this year
this is Idiocracy of 2021 right here.
Yeah, and it's frightening, because
it's so true.
Yeah, yeah.
I really think this could happen.
Yeah, I was watching this. And I was like, this is scary, because I do think that we are in a place in the world where there's something like this could happen. Maybe not quite as ridiculous, as it is a comedy drama. And sci-fi, I guess, right? Sci-fi. And
sci-fi comedy drama? I mean, does it even have it on here?
Comedy drama
sci-fi. Yeah, that's what they say.
So it's not Step Brothers, so don't expect that, because, you know, Adam McKay did Step Brothers, but now he's trying to step up. In this movie, for the most part, it lands. I like it.
Yeah.
It's got great performances. It's got really funny parts. I laugh out loud funny parts of this. And parts of this that are going to make you go like, fuck. You know, like a lot of that. I've seen some bad reviews of it too. And I think since it is a political movie, it's going to get polarized, and people are going to be scared to talk good or bad about it. you know? And the same thing is to talk poorly on this movie, but I actually liked this movie. I liked it. And
I really liked it. Everybody I watched it with, I was with four people. We all watched it together. The entire movie, we had a great time.
Solid performances from everyone. I mean, you get top-notch actors like Leonardo DiCaprio, Jennifer Lawrence, Meryl Streep, Kate Blanchett. You're going to get at least something good out of that, you know?
Yeah. And you get a Jonah Hill just playing one of his best comedic
roles. He was such an asshole. He was so funny.
He was such a comedic asshole.
Yeah. Yeah.
I liked it. I liked everything about this movie. I mean, the acting, again, Leo against Jennifer Lawrence. I mean, how is that not going to work?
Yeah.
How is that not going to work?
And
did he even say her name? Yeah. Melanie.
Linsky.
Yeah, Linsky was great. Ariana Grande fucking played her part exactly the way she needed to play. Even
Paul Guilfoyle was great. The general themes, like, it's like,
Ron Perlman with the fucking AK-47. God, he was amazing. He was so amazing. No, motherfuckers.
You will take me alive. Yeah.
Everybody played their part in this fucking movie, and I had a great time with it. It is teaching you a lesson.
Well, it is a lesson that I think, I do feel like people with me thought this movie was talking down to them. But I don't know, man. Like,
if you think this movie's talking down to you, you got issues, bro. Yeah. You got issues. And guess what? You getting all butthurt over this movie is not going to be the thing that solves it. You know,
I was into this movie. I liked it a lot. I'm surprised that the reviews are not as good as they could have been, but, for my money, both me and you, we like this movie. We recommend it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have quotes?
I don't quote you anymore.
Okay. Do you have quotes?
Do you have quotes? But I watched it with people, so I went back and looked up quotes I liked. So they're out of order. I just want you to tell you that. Way out of order. Mm-hmm. But you guys... The truth is way more depressing. They're not even smart enough to be as evil as you're giving them credit for.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you assholes are taking me to the Batcave, fuck you for putting this hood on me. I put the moment of impact in a diet app. So impact is when my diet ends. Only I'm not on a diet. I'm just crying 5 times a day. We really did everything, didn't we? I mean, we really did have everything, didn't we? I mean, when you really think about it, we really did. Why don't you mind your own business, you old fuck?
I laughed hard at that.
Yeah, I did too. The snacks are free. You ever see inside a man's torso? It changes you. Isn't that from Saving Private Ryan? Yeah, I'm sure that's from Saving Private Ryan. We'll lay out some newspapers and give you some Febreze. Not everyone needs to sound so goddamn clever or charming or likable all the time. And then I have news for you. It's already a complete disaster. And the quote of the movie. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. I've gone over it again and again and again in my head, and I still can't make sense of it. He's a 3-star general. He works at the Pentagon. Why would he charge us for snacks?
All right. So, I'm in Rotten Tomatoes. For people who are watching the show for the first time or listening to it.
Wait, we're not in Rotten Tomatoes yet.
Oh, yeah.
What's your score, bro?
My score on this is a 3.8.
3.8?
Yeah.
I'm going to go a little bit higher than you. I'm going to go 3.9.
Okay, take a shot for everyone who's playing the drinking game. You got that up? Ready to go?
Oh, the drinking game right there. Yeah.
So one drink when Neil was found something. So you already should have taken one now.
Yeah, you should have drank there. Because I mentioned Tulsa. Yeah. Fucked. We're fucked on that fucking thing right there.
Drinking. We talked about drinking while we.
We talked about my wife.
We were taking notes. Gosh. Wrestling. Oh, you mentioned that. I mentioned guitar. Well, I didn't tell you guys. I got a new guitar. Did you? It's beautiful.
I think we're getting people drunk. Yeah.
So one drink for now. We're 0.1 off from each other because we. I don't know. I like this movie, but it's a strange.
I like it a little bit better just because I'm not gonna lie. I belly laughed. I don't know if it's because I was stoned.
Watched the stoned, huh?
Oh, yeah, dude. It was on Christmas. Of course I was stoned.
Okay, fine.
I'm not drunk, it's not Christmas. If I'm not fucked up, it's not Hanukkah. All
right, so you give it a 3.9. 3.8, like I said, it was fine. I liked it, and I think it's a good movie. I don't know why I couldn't give it like more. It seemed a little long. There were parts that someone said.
I think that's your problem. I think you just thought it was a little long. I'm gonna give you that. It's probably your biggest thing.
Yeah, I liked it though. I liked the movie, and it was actually frightening. You know, like it was not a horror film, but you know, like seeing like how some people react to this, I'm like, obviously there are people out there that think a comet's not real. They're going to think that, you know, that I know people like that would say that it's a hoax, you know, that it's not true because nothing that awful could be lurking in their world. You know, Jesus Christ wouldn't do that to them, but here we are.
No, they wouldn't.
Why don't you go ahead? Now you have 3.9, right? Or 3.9, right? Okay.
Yeah. You said 3.8. Yeah. We all got that. Okay. Are you good with that?
Yeah, I'm good. 3.8 I'm fine with. Yes.
Okay. So on Rotten Tomatoes, I believe the audience gave this an 83%.
Not quite. 77.
Ooh, I'm five up, though. Yeah,
Not too bad.
I feel like I'm getting good at this.
There's no critics. There's no audience consensus. What's the critic score on this?
It's going to be something dumb, like 68%.
It's 54%.
Oh, I didn't go that low, but damn.
Critics consensus is, Don't Look Up aims too high for its scattershot barbs to consistently land, but Adam McKay's star-studded satire hits in a target of collective denial square on. Which is, man, it doesn't sound like a bad review. One of the ones I liked is from Linda Marg from the Jewish Chronicle said, very silly, yet undeniably urgent. I loved every second. Right?
I don't even know what to say to that. Yeah, I don't.
That's a good review. You know, like I like this movie. You know, it's
I really like this movie. This is one of those movies that you can throw it on, and even if I walked in a room and someone's like halfway through it, I could just sit down and watch it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And you know what? This is interesting. Matt Pace from MattPace.com said the new Idiocracy we deserve.
Me and him could be friends. We could be friends.
So the problem with this movie when it comes to news is there's not a whole lot of it, right?
I got some. Right. I got some I can mess around with I can fuck with you on. Ready?
I'm ready.
This is Movies That Don't Suck and Some That Do News. I'm going to say stuff that's been going on the last 7 days. And hopefully Chris loves it because I'm shoving it right in his ear holes.
I'm ready here. I've been kind of upset on the internet.
Are you ready?
So I'm ready.
So there's a story about a lady. Her name is Marlene Willis.
Marlene Willis.
Can you guess who she's the mother of?
Bruce Willis.
Correct! Good job.
Okay.
She tells TMZ, Die Hard is not a Christmas movie. Just like my son said before, it is a movie that is about action and family, It is set at Christmas time, but that's not an essential element of the movie, so it should not be considered a holiday classic along the lines of It's a Wonderful Life, How the Grinch Stole Christmas, and Home Alone.
Wait, you're one of those people that thinks it isn't a Christmas movie, right?
I am just going with the Willises, who were actually part of the fucking movie.
I have a machine gun. Ho, ho, ho.
Yes, he talked about hookers. I get it. Remember a couple weeks ago when Vin Diesel was all about, hey, man, hey, Rock, we need you in that final Fast and the Furious. We need you there.
And what did the Rock say?
Go fuck yourself.
Okay. And
then there was, that's not the exact words.
Wasn't there an impassioned plea from, oh boy, to reconsider?
Yeah, it was a plea. It was a big old plea.
Mm-hmm.
And the Rock said, I told Diesel directly that I would not be returning to the franchise. I was firm yet cordial with my words and said I would always be supportive of the cast and always root for the franchise to be successful, but that there was no chance I would return. Vin's recent public post was an example of his manipulation. I didn't like that he brought up his children in the post as well as Paul Walker's death. Leave them out of it. We had spoken months ago about this and came to a clear understanding. My goal all along was to end my amazing journey with the incredible franchise with gratitude and grace. It's unfortunate that this pilot public dialogue has muddled the waters. Regardless, I am confident in the Fast universe and its ability to constantly deliver for the audience. I truly wish my former co-stars and crew members the best of luck and success in the next chapter. You know why? Because he's the fucking Rock.
You can say that. You can do that.
He is. Look, how gracious of a guy does that sound like?
Pretty gracious, man. Pretty gracious. Like,
look, dude, I get it. I get it. But, man, I mean, yeah, would I have loved to have seen it? I would have. But, you know, Vincent D'Onofrio.
Vincent D'Onofrio. But Gomer Pyle himself, Full Metal Jacket.
Or also known as the Kingpin.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
In the MCU.
Oh, we started watching that. Me and wife finally started watching Daredevil. It's a perfect thing to watch on my new 4K television. It's so beautiful.
Like my 4K?
Yeah. But I'll be honest. Anyway. I honestly, it's 65 inches. That's fucking it's hard to mount on a wall. 65 inches.
I'm 65 inches. It's hard to mount.
Yeah. So you should see our entertainment center. There's like a half an inch on your side where the legs sit. I'm like, Jesus. So I was like, it might not fit, but yeah, dude, it's so great to watch.
I'm bragging about your TV. Nobody wants to hear you bragging about your TV. I was in the middle of a sentence, and you literally
I'm
just.
I'm so sorry. I just love it so much. Like, I honestly,
I get it.
I want to get the guitar. I want to get the guitar I bought on Christmas.
I got it. Huh. This is not compelling interview stuff.
Sorry.
For a movie podcast.
All right. I'm sorry.
What is, though?
Hey, Topher, do you play guitar? Sorry.
Okay. Is Topher here?
Yeah.
Topher.
He said, jump in? He said, that's what Dwayne Johnson said. And The Rock said,
yeah, go your hole and shut your mouth.
Yeah.
Oh, T-Dizzle. That's T-Dizzle. Mm-hmm. Vincent D'Onofrio wants to return as the Kingpin in the MCU as the next big bad guy. He wants to be the next Thanos.
But wasn't as the Kingpin, though?
Yeah.
Okay, I mean, I don't know how Kingpin can be... I don't know how he can be Thanos. He's just a man. Thanos is like this fucking alien.
Not Thanos! He wants to be the bad guy like Thanos was.
I don't know how
big... 28 movies led to Thanos?
Fine. So there should be 20 movies to Kingpin?
No. You do not know how the Marvel Universe works?
I do. Okay. I got you.
Oh, my gosh. All right. Hey, Tiger King getting sued again.
A different Tiger King or the same Tiger King? Because
same Tiger King.
Okay, because yeah, okay, so what's happened? Like, who's suing them?
Netflix is being sued over Tiger King.
Oh, why? By the Tiger King or someone else?
No, by Morgan Creek Productions, a.k.a. the people who have the copyright for Ace Ventura Pet Detective.
Ace Ventura Pet Detective. Yeah.
Because in the new Tiger King, they use two clips, which altogether runs about 5 seconds of screen time, in the new Tiger King documentary, the season two or whatever it was.
So how much are they suing them for?
Let's see here. It doesn't say. Oh, here it is. Damages totaling a long $350,000.
I don't know $350,000 is worth. I mean, some money for sure. They should have definitely got permission from Morgan Creek to use footage from Ace Ventura. I mean,
I think,
you think what?
I can't believe it. It's just, you know, I think sue him, whatever.
Finkel is Einhorn. Einhorn is Finkel.
Finkel is Einhorn. All right. You ready for this?
I'm ready.
The great, the wonderful, one of the most beautiful, awesome, funny women in all of history, who's turning 100 years old this year, has a stalker and really wish he would stop stalking her.
I think I did hear about this. Betty White's being stalked by who?
Ryan Reynolds.
Yes.
Yeah. And she would really like for Ryan Reynolds to stop, you know, stalking her. And Ryan Reynolds replied on Twitter, and he said, "I'm absolutely sick of the media exploiting past relationships just to drive up clicks."
That's funny. He's funny.
What a power couple that could be. Betty White, Ryan Reynolds. Let's make it happen.
Oh, we can make it happen. I'm not going to make it happen. It's all done.
So 3 days ago.
Yeah.
There is this social media lady. I don't know. I don't think she's good at anything. I think she was in a porno, and that was like the only thing she was good at. Named Kim Kardashian.
She was in a sex tape. Yes.
Yes. Okay. I think that's the only thing she's popular for besides her reality show. And she's one of those.
She got a big old booty.
And she's famous for being famous. Is that, that's the,
that's
term,
a thing. That's right? A thing. Yeah. It's definitely a thing. Yeah.
Well, she posted spoilers of the No Way Home Spider-Man on her Instagram.
I hope she got fucking banned. I hope she got kicked off.
How many millions of followers? I don't even know. But now the internet hates her.
She was on the way out, honestly, in the first place. So
anybody who didn't see the movie, don't go to Kim Kardashian's
Instagram.
Yeah, Instagram.
Stay away from it.
Because I don't know exactly what she said. A few of the film's most significant social as reported, Kim just shared photos of the movie's climactic third act on Instagram to her 273 million followers.
Why the fuck would she do that? What was she thinking?
Maybe she's like, man, I could be Mark Ruffalo.
Maybe.
You know, Mark Ruffalo, yeah. And his whole thing he did that one time. Yeah, okay. I thought it was funny. Yeah, anyway.
It's fine.
Peter Dinklage, man.
The Dink. He's going to be in that Toxic Avenger movie, right?
Yes. And that is what we're talking about.
Oh, okay.
He teases a crazy, over-the-top Toxic Avenger reboot. Mm-hmm. He says, and I quote, "It's a lot of fun. I just wanted to do something that I've never done before. So why not be a monster in an over-the-top, crazy movie? And why not sing in a musical as well?"
Oh, it's Cyrano, right? Cyrano that's coming out? Cyrano?
Yes.
Okay.
Correct. And then on top of that, he says, it's not a remake. I just like guerrilla filmmaking. Those films, they just made them no matter what. They just did it because they love doing it. Some of them are not the best, but some of them are so much fun. When you make movies too clean, it can distance the audience. They want to feel the dirt under their fingernails. I think those trauma films definitely dip the audience into toxic waste.
I'm looking forward to both those movies. I mean, we have to talk about Cyrano on the show, right?
I don't know. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right. And let's see here. Like I said, there wasn't much this week, guys. So I'm just trying to like dig through this stuff. Keanu Reeves is going to be the next movie we'll talk about. I'm going to do that new story last. I just realized that should probably be
the lead into the next one. Yeah.
The Ghostbusters Ultimate Collection includes a 114-minute never-seen preview cut the original 1984 movie.
Yeah,
but guess what movie is not in the new?
Yeah, the Paul Feig with Jennifer McCarthy and all those people in it.
But you do get a thing to download it. So if you want to download the movie.
Oh, it's actually, okay.
Yeah, there's a download card.
Okay.
But, 114-minute Ghostbusters.
I'll fucking watch that for sure.
I'll watch a six-hour Ghostbusters movie.
Yeah.
So guess who is the fashion icon of 2021 by Vogue magazine?
Is it Keanu Reeves?
No.
Who's it? Oh, let me guess.
Declared.
Is it Timothy Chalamet?
No. Is it?
For
their style of classically shub style of too baggy of clothing, it is now considered or called the Sandler Corps.
Wait.
Adam Sandler is declared 2021's fashion icon by Vogue because people during the pandemic have started to dress like Adam
Sandler.
That makes sense.
Because I could tell you, I walk around in my PJ pants almost everywhere. Except, you know, I actually put on pants when I leave. So that makes sense. It's kind of a ribbit, the Sandman, but you know, what are you going to do?
I'm sure he gives no fucks.
Oh, he gives zero fucks. He loves it.
He's Adam Sandler, man. Yeah. He don't give a shit. All right. Now, are you ready for this?
I like the movie, but yeah. So,
Keanu Reeves.
Yes.
Would like to add a new assassin to John Wick 5.
So I saw a link for this. I didn't click it. Who's going to be in John Wick 5?
He wants none other than Carrie Ann Moss to play one of the assassins the new John Wick 5.
She'd be great. She'd be awesome.
She'd be amazing. Yeah. It's fucking, I mean, if she's the assassin, I should say, that kills Keanu Reeves at the end, you know how awesome, how full circle that would be?
So are you saying you want John Wick to die?
I mean, in the fifth one, he kind of has to, right? Because it's the end of the story.
Oh, is that the last one? Is the next one the last one?
No, the next one's 4.
Okay.
We're only at John Wick 3 now.
Okay. I gotta be honest, I love John Wick. I do. And I can't wait to see the next one. Then it's done.
I mean, do you want him to come back when he's 90, like, you know, Sylvester Stallone in the Rocky movies, and the Creed movies?
Yeah, I don't know. You know? Yeah, you're right.
I don't know what you want from that, bro.
So is that...
But that's it, man. That's all the news. Let's wrap it up. That is the Movies Don't Suck. It's civilized news. I tell information to Chris, and he loves it.
I do want to mention next week is actually our top of 2021. So I don't think we're doing any new movies that week.
No, I guess that's what you said.
We can do one new movie. Oh, you're right. We might have a guest episode, so it'd be kind of full. So we will make up.
Yeah, and to be honest, discussing 10 movies each.
Yeah. No,
and 15, plus we have two.
Yeah, we have 15.
And we do our five five honorable mentions.
And then five worst.
And I don't know if you guys know how hard it is to go through. It
takes forever.
we do 52 weeks a year. 52 weeks a year.
We don't take a week off at all.
No, we'll do it different times of the week.
Yeah, yeah.
But we always go every week. I don't think we've canceled 1 week this whole entire year.
Not this year. We've done it once, and that was exceedingly circumstances. Guys, we are always on. So, like, it's
I'm always on because of all the cocaine in my nose. Woo!
All right, starting. This is
Wait. Topher, or T Dizzle. I'm sorry. I see that you're still on here. I want to put this up just for you. If you're drinking at home, here are the rules and the list to the new drinking game, T Dizzle. So, if you want to take a look at that and see how many drinks you need to catch up on.
just so you guys know, we did not make this drinking game. This is made by a friend of ours, and
it was made by one of our fellow listeners, mm-hmm. and he thought it was awesome. So I just thought I'd throw that up there for a second.
If you guys wanted to watch that listener talk about mead and making alcohol, check out the Mead House. It's a good podcast. Mm.
Right. The Mead House. Oh yeah, one of our good friends runs that, and he makes some really good meat too.
Dude, I get fucked. I'll tell you a quick little story. One day for my birthday, he came over, and I was pretty drunk already, but he brought over a beer bottle full of meat, and he said, "Chris, just so you know, this isn't beer. You have to pace yourself because it's packed with alcohol." And you know what I didn't do?
You didn't pace yourself because two beers makes Chris drunk.
Yeah. Imagine one bottle of mead. I was fucked up. And it was funny to people. Let's talk about the movie, the big sexy movie, The Matrix Resurrections, directed by Lana Wachowski. Along with her sister, they have made the Matrix movies, Jupiter Ascending, Cloud Atlas, which I like Cloud Atlas. A lot of people don't like it. I'm a big fan of it. Do you like Cloud Atlas? V for Vendetta, they're legends. They're fucking legends. Written by David Mitchell and David Alexander Hernon wrote the script for this. Just all kinds of stuff. And this stars the amazing Keanu Reeves.
When Ellen died, I lost everything.
Carrie Ann Moss as Trinity. And how many people do you think we've not seen Matrix that are listening to the show? If you had to guess.
None.
Okay, good. Carrie Moss is training.
Try this one. They were exposed to a toxic gas leak, or there's something in the water, or subliminal advertising.
Also, it's got Jennifer Henwick as Bugs.
And I am so happy to see you. I'm not the same person that I used to be, you know?
Also, it's got...
That was Jessica.
What did I say? Did I say Jessica?
And you said Jennifer.
I did not say Jennifer.
You said Jennifer. Rewind the fucking tape, dude.
Okay. Jessica Henwick. It's got Yael Martinez, two is Morpheus, Jonathan Groff Smith, and the amazing Neil Patrick Harris, NBH, as the analyst.
10 things I would have called my truck if Ted hadn't been a jerk and given it back.
Also, we got J.P.
and Smith. You didn't even give me one of them? You didn't even give me one of them?
I would have called my truck if Ted hadn't been a jerk and given it back. The Winnebago.
There we go. J.P. and Smith is Niobe. Christine Ricci is in this for a short minute as Gwen DeVere. Lambert Wilson is Mary. There's all kinds of people you've recognized from previous films. Neil, why don't you give the fucking tiny storyline this one? Oh, just so you guys know, we will be spoiling this one because I have questions. But, yeah, go ahead, Neil.
You have questions?
That I need answers from for you. So,
do you have any answers?
I hope you have answers. I really do.
Do you have answers? Because I have no answers.
Read the storyline.
I'll read your storyline. Mm. But anyway, return to a world of two realities. One, everyday life. The other, what lies behind it. To find out if his reality is a construct, to truly know himself, Mr. Anderson will have to choose to follow the white rabbit once more.
So,
mm-hmm.
this was a movie.
You're trying not to spoil it at all. You're just like, I don't know how to talk about this movie. Is that your problem?
No, I'm going to give general thoughts on it. But, like, again, like, you get nothing from the preview. You get a lot from the preview, but, again, you have questions that you want answered. And they kind of answer them, but kind of. The problem with this movie is it's really fucking messy. It's a messy movie. I have questions that I have fundamental questions. I have fundamental questions about the storyline that we can't talk about on this part of the episode, but I have fundamental questions and I have a problem with motivation. I will say this, and it's very fucking meta. It's very, very, very meta. Wachowski is part of it because they said, we're going to make this movie without you or not. Right? Oh, she's like, okay, I'll make the fucking anti-sequel. Pretty much. She said, I'm going to make the anti-sequel, which is great. But I think she got too meta with it. I think that she went ahead and said, I'm going to make this as weird as possible. Or I'm going to make it super meta. So that means I'm going to make the movie suffer for it. Because to me, I did not like this movie. Right away. I love Keanu Reeves. I love Carrie Ann Moss. I love the Matrix movies. I did not like this movie. I don't know why it exists. I have a problem with storyline motivation. And honestly, I didn't like it, man. I like the characters. It's hard not to like Keanu Reeves. It's hard not to like Neil Patrick Harris because I like those characters. But the movie itself was a bunch of cool ideas that are executed poorly. And I feel bad saying this. I was mildly excited for this, but I had my reservations, and sadly my reservations were confirmed when I spent 2.5 hours watching this. I have problems with I don't have a problem with the acting, because I know Connery is act. He's I can see him do anything. I can see him eat a peanut butter sandwich. I'd be pleased with it. I can see Carrie Ann Moss do anything. I can see Neil Patrick Harris do anything. I can see Yahoo Demetine second playing his Morpheus. Fucking fantastic. All the actors did their jobs, but this is a movie with ideas that are bad. Or they're good, but they weren't executed correctly. So when we get to the spoiler section, I'm going to ask you a question. I hope you have answers, because I have serious problems with this movie. Serious problems. And I'm sorry, I didn't like not like this movie. I'm not going to go there and say it sucks, but I'm going to say that as a person who liked The Matrix, looking forward to this, I was disappointed. And I think Lana made a bad decision by making it so fucking meta and such an anti-sequel that I think that I just didn't like this movie. I'm sorry, I'm done now. You're looking at me like I'm a monster, and I'm sorry.
You're doing a crazy rant. Now I'm just watching it, man. Yeah. I'm watching you fly with it. All right, Chris, my turn. Okay. Guess what? Hold my beer.
Yeah.
All right. Let me put everything that Chris said in a slower, more methodic, easier tone.
Oh, by the way, this movie's very polarizing. The movie's very polarizing. The people that love it, the people that hate it. I didn't hate it, but I didn't like it. But go ahead. I'm sorry. I just needed to put that out there before Neil gave his thoughts on this movie. I'm sorry.
Are you done?
Yeah, I'm done.
Can I talk now?
You may talk.
Okay.
Okay.
This movie had an idea.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was a good idea. I like the idea that they had.
Uh-huh.
They should have played with that idea a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
And I get why this movie is the way it is.
Yeah.
But because of that idea, I feel like this movie is two different movies. Like, I feel like there's a certain point where, now you could say the same thing as maybe the original Matrix.
Yeah, but I feel like that's dumb.
Where it gets to a point where it's kind of like, it's completely, but this, I would have to say, is 100% did not get executed well at all.
Yeah.
Do I like the idea of it? Yes.
Yeah, cool idea.
Do I like how they executed the idea? No. There was several actors they should have brought back. The two main ones, because let's be honest, Matrix 1, 2, and 3 wasn't just because of Keanu Reeves and Carrie Ann Moss.
Yeah.
As much as I love both of those actors, and I do, I love Carrie Ann Moss and everything from Suspect Zero to Jessica Jones. And Keanu Reeves, I love him in every, I even love him in Point Break. You know, it's
yeah.
Like, oh, I am an FBI agent. You know, like, I love him. I love him. Great dude. Awesome energy. But there was two major stars missing from this movie.
Yeah, one's just friend. It's one of them.
Lawrence Fishburne.
I don't know why. Hugo Weaving, he had other issues, asked him to come back, but he had other commitments. He was doing theater or something.
Yeah, he had other commitment theater work. Great. Schedule around it. Use a fucking green screen and a goddamn tennis ball and just put them in it later. It is fucking 2021, guys.
And
Star Wars shows, they're not in a different fucking galaxy, but they can literally film at four different parts in the goddamn world, and nobody has a problem with it. But you can't film another guy in New York and people that are in San Francisco? What the fuck?
They didn't ask Lawrence Fishburne. They didn't even ask him.
No. And you know what? Lawrence Fishburne did not age badly.
Black don't crack, dude.
All right?
Black don't crack.
You're going to put him in there. You're going to de-agentize him like a little bit. Not much. Not as much as they had to do Samuel L. Jackson and freaking Captain Marvel. But, like, for real, those two people, and I'm not going against, I'm not saying that, what's his name? Abdul-Mateen II. I'm not saying him or Jonathan Groff did not do their part or try to play their part. I got it. They tried.
I thought Jessica Henwick was his Bugs. I thought that was probably...
They did the same thing with the Oracle.
Yeah, I know.
And the other movies, because of the passing away of the Oracle, which, you know, I understood they were in a tight spot there or whatever. But the two guys are still alive. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They're still out there. And
so also
Neil Patrick Harris as the analyst.
Great.
And I'm gonna say this right now. Best villain role he's ever played, and I'm a big fan of Lemony Snicket's. So like
Dr. Horrible, you know, right there.
Dr. Horrible. Yeah. He did a great job as the bad guy, the therapist, the analyst, whatever he was. In this movie, they had other cameos of people from the other movie of the movies pop in, like Lambert Wilson, Jada Pinkett Smith, the little girl. But I don't even think it was the same actress, though. I'd have to look that up.
Yeah.
But something didn't fit right.
Also, all the sort of like the because what Delano was trying to do was say, hey. This is a criticizing the Hollywood machine and the 24-hour news cycle and the need for extra content. I'm like, we get it. But this movie, this wasn't your mood to sound off on when it came to that. It's completely, it's the fourth one. And I don't, you kind of want to be in the same lane as those other movies. So don't come here and saying, well, this is the anti-sequel. I'm like, I get that. It's fine. It's the anti-sequel, but this was not done well at all.
This was not good at all, man.
Yeah.
I'm not a fan of it. I love the Matrix movies, man. Yeah, I'm not going to lie to you.
They're good. They didn't need a fourth one, though. Like, but we'll get to that when we spoil this. Okay?
But, yeah, and I think this could have been a great 100%. I think this could have been a great movie. I think it could have.
You know what's really weird about this movie is it seems small. Right? Did it seem small?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, like we have these other movies. We have Matrix and Matrix Revolutions. Those seemed like giant, big fucking movies. Giant movies. But this feels like a low budget version of this. You know? Yeah, dude, keep doing that. Leave that up. Just so you guys know, Neil's finally playing with Restream. He has our Twitter handle on there, finally.
I never have time to play with this shit, man. I'm sorry. But, by any means, I want this to be better. I wanted this to be better. Yeah. That's my thing. Besides that, that's all I have to say right now. I mean, we're going to do a spoiler thing, and I'm kind of at that point now where all I can say is the acting, good.
Yeah.
The idea or concept, yeah, really good. I really like this concept, especially for what it was. The main good parts of this movie was Keanu Reeves and Neil Patrick Harris against each other. Like, anytime they were on the screen together, worked out great. Carrie Ann Moss and Keanu Reeves on the screen together, great. Like, they have chemistry, they always have. They could be in a TV series for 400 years and nobody would care. But there's just some parts to this that I was just like, man, I don't know, dude.
It didn't work.
I mean, it's not that I'm trying to be an ass or anything like that, but it's just like, I wanted this to be so much better, you know?
Yeah, I did too. You get quotes?
I got your face.
Yeah, we get quotes and then we'll get our score.
I just noticed something because you've been popping up those things and I haven't been doing the promotions. Our Twitter hasn't had a single tweet since December 8th.
When the fuck, dude? Really?
Yeah, you haven't posted anything anywhere else.
Okay, fine. I will start posting.
How about you just tell me when stuff is coming out, and I'll just do this shit. Do the work.
All right, fine.
I missed 1 week, and you took it away from me.
Here's the thing. If you go on our mobile, Facebook mobile, our episodes are automatically posted on our Facebook. But if
you still repost stuff.
Yeah, I do. But if you look on desktop, those episodes aren't there.
Weird.
It is weird. But yeah, okay. But if you look on your phone, our new episodes are uploaded automatically.
You have failed me for the last time, Chris.
All right, what's
quotes. Who does the quotes?
Huh?
Oh, you want me to do quotes from the movie?
Yes, for Matrix Resurrections.
Man, yes, I did not know that.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, you did. Did we?
I don't know.
Did you write down quotes with this? Of course you did.
What? Yeah. No, okay. Now, if that's Trinity, then that's not what happens. The more I looked, the more I found. The choice is an illusion. You already know what to do. I'm a geek and I was raised by machines. It's so perfect, it's gotta be fake. That's the thing about stories. They never really end, do they? Originally and fresh are key words as you work on Matrix 4. Oh, originality and fresh are key words as you work on Matrix 4. I love my bad writing. Ideas are the new sexy. My youngest stuck a Lego up his nose. You have to let it go. Free your mind, Neo. Welcome back to the real world. Could this be the first day of the rest of your life? They took my life and turned it into a video game. I'm sure as shit never seen this coming. Nothing travels faster than the speed of light, except gossip. This is not independence of mine. This is mutiny. I still know Kung Fu. I won't have his leash on my neck again. I had dreams that weren't just dreams. The world doesn't end when you do. People stay in their little pods happier than pigs and shit. That's good. I'm good on that.
All right. Why don't you give your score first?
Oh, man. I love Keanu Reeves. I love Keanu Reeves. I love Keanu Reeves.
Spit it out, 2. Dude.
2.2, man.
2.2?
3.2.
Okay. I'm going a little bit lower than you. Maybe 2.8.
Yeah.
This is not a good movie.
You know, I was thinking about that. And I just didn't know what to say. I mean, let's get to the things. Let's get to it so okay. We can finish this all.
So, what's the audience score on Tomatoes for this?
That?
What's the audience score on this on Rotten Tomatoes?
The audience score on this is, I'm going to say 67%.
You call it 63.
Wow.
So what's the critic score on this?
Forty-two.
64 actually.
Really? They went higher?
Yeah, critic consensus is if it lacks the original's bracelet and the original craft, the Matrix Resurrections revisits the world of the franchise with wit, a timely perspective, and heart. They gave this a better review than I did. Okay, so we're going to give you guys 10 seconds. I'm going to give you guys 10 seconds to leave the podcast, and we'll be doing the rest of 2021 next week, so stick around for that. Blah, 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 blah. 10 seconds. I'll play something in the meantime. Yep. All right, so starting now, this movie. Oh, look at us. We're so young and beautiful. We're skinnier, too, in that photo, aren't we?
Yeah, because we're not older, fat, and lazy, okay. And a pandemic didn't happen.
Okay. All right, yeah, pandemic didn't happen. Pandemic is like, you didn't get sick, but here's a bunch of weight. I was like, oh. Yeah.
You know how much I really wanted, I really want to go out and sing karaoke?
Yeah.
I have not gone out and sung karaoke in so long.
Yeah.
But how can I share a microphone with people right now? Yeah.
So, this movie didn't need to get fucking made.
It didn't. But, again, it had a great idea. They just fucked it up on every turn.
Quick question. Everywhere.
The only thing good they did in this whole fucking movie is they casted Keanu Reeves, they casted Carrion Moss, and they casted Neil Patrick Harris. Those three made the whole movie. Why the fuck wasn't Lawrence Fishburne there? Why the fuck wasn't Hugo Weaving there? And why the fuck did it not make any sense? And like this new team or whatever. Well, let me ask you a question.
Why the fuck did they even come get Neo? It didn't make any sense. Like they got him. Like, what are you doing after that? Nothing. There was no stakes whatsoever in this whole fucking movie. I couldn't stand it.
Morpheus woke up in his new body or whatever it was. And that is what made.
But there's no stakes. Why did they get him? Why did they get him? There's no stakes.
Because there was stakes.
What's the stakes? Why did they bring Neo back? What was the point?
Everyone was back in hiding and the machines were looking to kill him still.
No.
So they had to be more creative. No. They made it very clear. I watched the movie twice.
They could kill Morpheus, too. And they brought Morpheus, who was a threat to Io, a threat to the new city. And I don't know why this was a movie. I don't know why they brought him back. There's no motivation, no stakes whatsoever in this whole fucking thing. I couldn't stand it. I was losing my fucking mind. I was like, okay, next one.
I'm gonna answer these two answers right here. One, Morpheus rewoke himself, even though he was now an agent, which would have been better if Lawrence fucking Fishburne was playing the part. Then you'd be like, why is he an agent? We know who that is. That's fucking Morpheus. But we didn't get that. You know? And then number two is this, because they stopped waking up people. Remember? Yeah. Like, it was a big part of the speech was like, we don't care about waking up people anymore. We're just, okay, those people fuck off. We're just going to grow our little garden.
So here's the thing, man. The fight scenes were pretty fucking kind of lame. Like, you remember Neo? He was a fucking kickass. Why is
that? Except for some of the worst CGI from that time. Let's just be honest. But
Keanu Reeves, why is Neo? You almost get his ass kicked at every turn in this movie. Almost like dying. And they use that fucking force push. Like, what is going on? Like to me, I don't like this movie. I don't think it, right, so I don't think it needs to it. Exist.
All right. This is the three ways we can make it. The three ways we could have made it better. One, have the actors that are supposed to be there. If you had Hugo Weaving and fucking Lawrence Fishburne there, then those two as Agent Smith and as Morpheus, no matter if they're 105 years old, Neo age, Carrie Ann Moss age, fuck it. Let them age too. Don't care. Would have been perfectly fine. That's number one. Number two, when Neo remembers he's Neo, straight back, give him all his powers. Because guess what? He remembers who he was. He remembers he's the one.
He knows Kung Fu.
Yeah. Fucking don't peter around with him being in his room going, I don't even know why I'm here. You know, like,
well, I asked myself that question when I was watching the movie. I get that.
And wait. I had three. Okay. Let me finish my point, dude. And then you can go on your 5.5 hour rant again. Number three is don't overcomplicate.
So complicated.
You know what I mean? So what they did is they overcomplicated it, right? If they would have made it, hey, Jada Pinkett Smith is now leading the group in Io. Is now leading the group. She's not leading the group the way it should be because she's not waking up people anymore. She's not taking risks. She's just planting food and trying to figure out how we can have food that kind of tastes like the shit that we ate in the Matrix. All right. If you made it where she was more of a bad guy than a good guy, you know what I mean? Where she was like, hey, fuck you. I don't want you guys waking up anybody else. I don't want Neo to be here anymore. I don't want fucking Morpheus to return. Fuck all you guys. No. And made her more of like a bad guy. And instead of just someone that is kind of just got different ideas, but you got to make her of a bad guy being on the side of pretty much making it so nobody can fight the machines. Then you're vindicated on why that all this is happening. Because now you got people like, hey, we need to find Morpheus and Neo. We know they're in the Matrix because if we find them, they're going to help us go against the machines again, like they did back in the past.
Yeah.
They just overcomplicated the script way too much. Yep. You could have fucking just got all the nostalgia out of this motherfucker and made it a very simple story. Because you can made it Neo is Thomas Anderson, the video game maker who made the Matrix video games. That's how everybody knows him. And Then the people come to come find him and Morpheus because they want to wake people up and get them not be batteries anymore. But that's not how they did this.
It's way too meta for me. And maybe I'm a dork or something, but I just...
What's meta mean?
Meta? Self-aware. You know, they make a sequel to The Matrix. You know, like, that was the meta. Because they were self-referential. Everything was talking about the Hollywood machine in a roundabout way. Because Alana was dealing with shit. So, I didn't like this movie. I thought the action was kind of shitty. I thought the storyline was fucking ridiculous. Fucking ridiculous. This was far from necessary. Far from necessary. It didn't need to get made, dude. I don't understand it. I don't understand why it was made. And also, their reason for not bringing Lance Lawrence Fishburne is a bad reason. It still didn't make sense to me. It didn't work. It didn't work, and that's...
And I agree on that. I agree that it could have worked better. Like I said, those three reasons right there. That's how this movie could have been three times better.
It's also two and a half hours long of this. This thing's way too long for what they showed us.
Right. And by any means, I love everything in the world. I love the Matrix world. I even liked the ones that everybody didn't like. You know what I'm saying? Like... I liked the three movies that were great, but I just really, really wish this had more to it. Like, I wanted it to be better. I wanted it to, I don't know, man. There's something about this movie that just makes me, I'm just looking for more, you know? I was looking for more. I didn't get it.
Give me a blue pill, man.
Huh?
Give me a blue pill. I want to forget this movie.
Give me a blue pill. I want to forget this movie.
Yeah.
I want to forget that it existed. I, to myself, think every day, gosh, I could erase this from existence like people wish they could erase other things from existence. I'm just saying, I'm pretty sure there's stuff out there that people want to erase.
Just so you guys know, that's not me, that's my brother. And it's become a meme, I feel like.
It's so hilarious.
All right, guys. I think that's all we had to say about this movie.
That's all we got to say to the movie.
Next week,
they tried.
They tried.
Let's say they tried. They tried, and you know,
swing and miss for me.
You're gonna swing and miss when I hit you in the butt.
Next week, we're talking about best of 2021. We're gonna have a guest with us, probably.
Oh my gosh. That means I have to go through all this shit. Yeah, I have to go through all these movies. Yeah, all of them.
Yeah, well, our guest already put his together. So check our email.
Oh, Harry got it?
Yeah.
Did he really?
Check his email.
Oh, man. I don't want to check the email. Fuck that. You know why?
Why?
Because I like to live deliciously.
Nice. Why do you put that up there? It's a good tattoo I got. And it's so amazing.
It is a great tattoo.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Follow us online with Zone Slip Down Network.
You know, I have a whole folder on my computer of just you.
What's it
called?
Is
that weird?
Yeah, it's kind of weird.
Chris. It's cold. Okay. Well, I mean, we do stuff on here, and I was trying to use stuff to manipulate it to make it look cool when, you know, I was doing Photoshop a lot. You want to see it? Here, I'll do one picture real quick that will make you happy. Are you ready for this one?
Yeah.
This is kind of cool. This makes you see how cool Neil is.
Okay.
Are you ready for this?
Yeah, I'm ready for it.
Are you sure you're ready for this?
I'm fucking born ready.
All right, there you go.
Oh, that's you, David Koechner. Yeah.
St.
Patrick's Day. Follow us on LinguageDon'tSuck.net. We're on Facebook at Facebook.com/LinguageDon'tSuckPodcast. We're on Twitter at LinguageDon'tSuckPodcast. We're on Instagram at LinguageDon'tSuckPodcast. You can find us on Patreon, Patreon.com/LinguageDon'tSuck. We have shirts and stuff. Go to Bonfire.com/LinguageDon'tSuck. And some of you will find merch with us on it. Or if you're on YouTube, go and subscribe. Watch on Twitch, go and subscribe. Watch on Facebook, go and like, subscribe. And we're on all streaming platforms. We're a place you find podcasts. You can find movies and so Don't Suck and some they do. What do you do for small business, pal?
If you're a small business, please, please just let us know. We'll be more than happy to help advertise your business right here at Movies Don't Suck and Some That Do. We'll be more than happy to give your information out to the world. So please just contact us either at our email, Twitter, anywhere of the above, and we'll be more than happy to help you out just by giving you free advertisement to all our thousands of listeners, our millions of followers. Right?
Yeah, I don't think it's millions. I don't think it's,
it's millions.
I think you can say thousand. But not thousands. Thousands.
Millions. You can't say stuff like that, dude.
Okay, fine, fine.
Always upplay your product, don't you know?
Okay, all right, fine.
Always upplay your product, man. Okay,
all right, upplay. Gotcha. Are you good?
Are you good? That's another episode of Movies Don't Suck and Something I Do. This is Neil.
I'm Chris.
And remember, guys, anytime you're walking through a video game thinking that you're someone or someone else, remember, just don't look up at the sky because we're all going to die. Have a good New Year's!